Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. Manual transmissions are considered a dying breed, much like the dinosaurs. Until quite recently, vocal proponents were adamant that the world's cars would be entirely replaced by battery EVs in the not-too-distant future. With very few exceptions, battery EVs don't even have a transmission to begin with. Even the transmissions in those few exceptions are electronically controlled, leaving no room for the driver to get involved. Even after the massive wave of battery EV hype has subsided, car manufacturers must still continue to reduce their CO2 emissions. This is because they will be faced with heavy fines. To mitigate these fines as much as possible, they have chosen to focus on hybrid vehicles. While some hybrids don't have a transmission, there are quite a few types that do. However, those transmissions are typically ECVTs, step ATs, or DCTs, all of which require no shifting from the driver. Will the manual transmission, after all, suffer the same fate as the dinosaurs? That was precisely when Fiat stepped in and announced a hybrid model equipped with a manual transmission. Now, to all you manual transmission lovers out there, let's say a big thank you to Fiat. That being said, this turn of events isn't actually good news for manual lovers. In this video, we'll explore the story behind the Fiat 500 Hybrid and its mechanical structure. Based on the strategy of its parent company Stellantis, Fiat has set an ambitious goal to become a fully electric brand by 2030. To this end, they developed a dedicated battery EV platform for the 500e and invested 700 million euros to establish a dedicated battery EV production line at the Mirafiori plant in Turin, with an annual capacity of 100,000 units. Initially, sales of the Fiat 500e were strong. Sales reached 10,000 units in 2020. Followed by 44,000 in 2021, 66,000 in 2022, and 65,000 in 2023. However, in 2024, the momentum came to a screeching halt. Sales totaled only 18,500 units in the first 8 months. Compared to 52,000 units during the same period in 2023, this represents just 36% of the previous year's volume. As a result, the Mirafiori plant underwent multiple extended production halts between 2024 and 2025. Unfortunately, they messed up. However, it would be harsh to blame the management. Even though the Italian government opposed it, the EU was pushing to phase out gasoline-powered vehicles, so it would have been difficult to go against that. That said, the EU will not compensate for the reduced production volumes. As a desperate measure, they came up with the idea of modifying the battery EV dedicated platform for internal combustion engines and installing an existing engine and transmission into it. To emphasize, they took that modified platform and equipped it with the existing powertrain system used in models like the Pandina. There was no other choice. The production lines were shut down, leaving no time to develop a new hybrid system. Web news outlets are praising Fiat's decision, framing the manual-only 500 hybrid as sporty and a choice that prioritizes the joy of driving. But the truth is, Fiat simply don't have a hybrid system that paired a 1.0-liter engine with an automatic transmission. So, no matter how cute and fun to drive the 500 hybrid may be, it doesn't provide a roadmap for the manual transmission's survival in the age of hybridization. Feeling a bit let down, we will explore the actual system configuration of the 500 Hybrid in the next chapter. The Fiat 500 Hybrid features a mild hybrid system equipped with a BSG. A mild hybrid is a system that cannot propel a vehicle using the electric motor alone. However, in recent years, manufacturers such as Stellantis and Audi have begun to label systems that can drive on electric power alone as mild hybrids, making the classification increasingly ambiguous. To keep things simple, in this video, we'll refer to systems that cannot propel the vehicle by the motor alone as mild hybrids. BSG is an abbreviation for Bell-Driven Integrated Starter Generator. Conventional gasoline engines have a starter motor and an alternator built into them. Starter motors are DC, direct current, motors powered by a 12-volt battery and used to crank the engine. Alternators are alternating current generators that supply power to the vehicle's electrical systems and charge the battery. The alternating current is converted to direct current by a rectifier, and the voltage is regulated between 13 and 15 volts by a voltage regulator. Here is an animation of the electric motor principle. When electricity flows through the coil, the interaction between electricity and magnetism causes the coil to rotate. Starter motors utilize this principle to function. Conversely, when the coil is rotated by an external force, it generates electricity. In other words, a motor can also function as a generator. Alternators utilize this principle to function. Thus, the functions of the starter motor and the alternator can be combined into a single component. That is what a BSG is. When supplied with electricity, the BSG acts as a starter motor, and when driven by rotational force, it functions as a generator. The BSG is a three-phase AC motor controlled by an inverter. When operating the BSG as a starter motor, the inverter sequentially switches the current flowing to the motor coils to rotational force. When operating as a generator, the inverter adjusts the power output by controlling the duration for which the circuit between the battery and the BSG is closed. During ignition switch operation, or recovery from the start-stop function, the inverter supplies electrical power to the BSG, which operates as a starter motor to crank the engine. Once the engine is running, the BSG functions as a generator to power the vehicle's electrical components as well as charge the battery. During vehicle launch and acceleration, the BSG operates as a traction motor to assist the engine. As you can see, the 500 hybrid cannot drive on electric power alone. Furthermore, because the Fiat system operates on a 12-volt architecture, the power output is relatively modest. For reference, let's compare it with BSG-based mild hybrid systems from other manufacturers. Please note that the maximum torque figure for Fiat's BSG is not an official specification. Since the BSG uses a rubber belt for power transmission, it cannot be paired with a high-output motor. For this reason, any improvements in acceleration or fuel performance are limited. If car manufacturers are to consider preserving manual transmissions for enthusiasts, under increasingly stringent CO2 emissions regulations, they will need to combine them with a full-fledged hybrid system. Mazda MX-5, Toyota GR86, Porsche 7-18, and Ford Mustang. I sincerely hope that the beloved manual transmission, now becoming increasingly rare, will survive into the hybrid era. From this perspective, while 500 hybrid may be far from perfect, perhaps we should offer Fiat a somewhat reluctant thank you for introducing a hybrid model with a manual transmission. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.